What's up, Giants fans, Hub watchers, YouTube subscribers, Twitter and Instagram followers? It's your boy Kush back at it again with another New York Giants update video. Today's video really just a, you know, middle of the week injury update situation for the Giants. Not really injury, just, you know, an update on the status of a couple of players. One player that I count as, you know, kind of important towards the Giants, and then two other ones that are more, you know, it slot into the role players, rotational guys type stuff. But nevertheless, still news I want to get out to you guys. And let's get right into it. First and foremost, hit that like button, subscribe, and share if you have not already. Hit that post notifications bell, because sometimes YouTube be tripping when it comes to sending you guys notifications about when I upload. Also, the skit is already up. So first thing and first player is David Sills, number 84, the wide receiver for the New York Giants. Kind of been a forgotten soul as the season went on. Not necessarily his fault, though. You know, he was on IR for how long, man? I want to say basically since training camp. You know what I'm saying? The dude been on IR since then. He is designated for return from IR, and he's been placed on the reserve / COVID-19 list this week. So now, according to this article that I'm reading here from Giants Wire, it says that clubs are not allowed to disclose whether a player has tested positive or is quarantining due to close contact with someone who has. Prior to landing on IR, Sills had a tremendous training camp for the Giants and was frequently referred to as a rep stealer. Now, before I get into that, you know, the rep stealer type of thing, which is a nickname given to him by Tyke Tolbert, our wide receivers coach, the reason this, you know, kind of news story here interests me is that I'm wondering whether or not the Jason Garrett, you know, little outbreak situation has been completely contained or not. Or you could even go all the way back to Will Hernandez. What was that, middle of the season? Because I think Will Hernandez was the first player to contract COVID on our team. Correct me if I'm wrong there. Then obviously, you know, we had the scare with the entire offensive line. A couple other players got it. Then Jason Garrett got it. And, you know, in my video reporting on that, I was wondering to myself, how in the world did Jason Garrett get it, but not one offensive player, you know, got it from him? That doesn't make any sense to me. If he is, and if there's the he being David Sills, if he is being quarantined because he may or may not have tested positive for COVID or is showing signs, I'm worrying about the other players on our team, because this is David Sills, somebody that's been on IR. Now, he's still in contact with the team. You know, he's probably still there for practices, you know, team meetings and whatnot. But he has limited, compared to a regular wide receiver, say Darius Slayton or something, very, very limited contact with our offensive coordinator compared to those guys. So if somehow, some way, David has contracted it, then I am worrying about our regular players, you know what I'm saying? So that is definitely something we need to think about entering week 17. It would be really, really, you know, terrible, sad, and disappointing if, you know, our wide receiving core, which has finally gotten a bit healthy, now they just need to hold on to the football. It is the last week of the season, though, and I can't believe I'm saying this, but we're finally, like, a healthy wide receiving core, have been for a couple of weeks now. It would be crazy if that gets completely derailed because of another COVID scare or something like that, and then in a week 17 game with playoff implications on the line, we lose because of that. That would be absolutely crazy. But keep your eye on it, guys. Be on the lookout, and let's hope that the Giants are very diligent with this and take it as a serious matter. You know what I'm saying? The next player is going to be kind of a short one that is also designated from return from injury reserve is Madre Harper, defensive back. He's been designated for return from IR and could return to practice as early as Wednesday afternoon. So that is this afternoon. In 9 games for the Giants this season, Harper recorded 5 tackles and recovered 1 fumble. Now, I'm not expecting much from Madre Harper, another name that I'm assuming a lot of us kind of forgot about. I'm not going to complain about getting help in the secondary, though. We could use as much help as we can. Harper is not somebody that, you know, I want out there getting secondary reps, but he's definitely somebody I wouldn't mind having out there on the special teams. And you know what? Maybe him going back on the team on special teams might do some for us, because he's been on IR for a good couple of weeks now. maybe we were missing some players in the special teams, and that's why we were seeing a decrease in production and honestly kind of a little bit of regression from that unit. It's definitely a stretch. I'm just throwing the idea out there. But I think we have all noticed since, I want to say, the Bengals game coming off the bye week, the special teams have been bad. You know what I'm saying? They've been bad. They've been really bad in coverage. They've been really bad in stopping other teams from making a complete run on us. It just hasn't been good special teams play, tackling and whatnot, and taking angles from the New York Giants since essentially week 12 of the NFL season. And if we're going to try and make any type of run here, or at the very least, if we're just going to try and beat Dallas so that we could beat Dallas for the first time in 4 years like we beat the Eagles, we're going to need our special teams to be on par. Like I said, it's a stretch, and I don't want Marjorie Harper out there playing, you know, consistent secondary reps at all, because he's, you know, he's a backup player, he's a depth player, he's a rotational guy. I would not mind him being on special teams though, which, you know, he was used on there when healthy. And maybe, I don't know, maybe the special teams was missing some guys we didn't realize because we don't keep our eyes on it like that. But hey, if Marjorie Harper could come back and help us in that asset, then I'm going to be glad for that as well. But the most important player out of this bunch right here, like I mentioned earlier on, is going to be Kyler Fackrell. And he is looking towards a week 17 return. Now, Kyler was actually supposed to return last week against the Ravens. That's the reports that was coming out, and I actually expected him to play, but right before the game started, he was not activated. But that's been really the story of Kyler Fackrell for the past 2 weeks or so. He's been, what, injured since week 12? You know, after starting 7 straight games for the Giants and, you know, being one of our better edge rushers, that's not saying much, but he is one of our better edge rushers. He's our best edge rushing option right now, considering the health of the team. He's definitely better than Cam Brown and Carter Coughlin as of right now. You know what I'm saying? He can definitely get a little bit of pressure from the edge. And we all know what he did against Dallas the last time we played them. Is this surprising? This man has the only pick six of the Giants' entire season. Like, that just hit me. Am I wrong about that? Or, like, is that just in my head? Like, does he not have the only pick six of the entire Giants season? Think about that for a second. He has a pretty good skill set on him. There is a reason we brought him and Blake over from Green Bay. It's because, of course, Patrick Graham has good experience with them. I'm not expecting him to be a world beater or anything against Dallas, but I am expecting better production from the edge this week if he does suit up. I like Kyler Fackrell. You know what I'm saying? He's a guy we got on a really cheap deal, and he's definitely lived up to that deal. He's surpassed that deal. If he was healthy the entire season, I'm sure we could have had some good production out of him. And I am expecting, you know, good things from him this week should he suit up. Also, maybe he could work a little bit of that magic like he did last time against Dallas and help us get a turnover or whatnot. But really would be excited to see Kyler Fackrell back. There's nothing official on it just yet. Just this article here from CBSSports.com, reported by our favorite Giants reporter Jordan Renan, saying that he's expected to return from IR and suit up against the Cowboys on Sunday. We'll see how that story develops. But that's what I got for y'all today. 3 short updates, 3 different type of updates with 3 different type of implications. Let me know what you all think. Like, share, subscribe, and I'm out. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. I'll catch y'all in the next one.